Hey everybody, today I am going to alter this board purse that I found at a My Crafty thrift store, and I thought it was really adorable and I wanted to kind of make it pretty instead of just this white. There's so many possibilities for this, but I wanted to decorate it and send it to a friend. And I'm hoping that by the time this video is uploaded, she has received it. And yeah, so what I'm doing is I'm going to decorate it with the Maggie Holmes Carousel Collection, which is absolutely my favorite. I've talked about it so much before, so I'm going to use it for this board purse. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to trace the board onto some paper. And this I got in the open stock at Joann's. And I'm going to do double of them. And as you can see, it completely covered it. But I want it to show a little bit of the white part on the outside, so I'm gonna make it a tad bit, probably like a quarter inch smaller. And I'm also going to cut off the sides and make them an individual part as opposed to having them completely all together. So there we go, those two and those two. Now I'm gonna go on through the inside and, like I did before, cut a smidge off just so that the white part of the board can be seen through. There we go. I didn't use anything fancy, no machine. I didn't do any measurements. I literally grabbed the paper and I just kind of eyeballed it where I wanted to cut it and measure it, and that's it. Of course, there's other methods of doing this perfect, but I wanted to show a form of not having to use a machine or anything. I went off and I did some sewing, stitching along the edges. And I used some hot glue to glue down the first one, and I didn't like the way it looked. It looked bubbly, so I ended up transferring to a liquid glue. And yeah, so I sewed on all four pieces, and I thought it looked really well. I'm not doing the bottom because it's going to be sitting on the bottom and you can't really see. Then I'm gonna use my Distress inks, which I also got at the thrift a while ago. And I'm using the Mermaid Lagoon to distress the ends of the board. I think it'll give it a nice kind of color with all the rest of the colors that I'm going to use with this collection. And I think it's looking pretty good so far. And I just turned on the camera. I didn't have any rhyme or reason or planned out anything. The only thing I planned out is that I knew I wanted to use this collection. And I got a lot of requests asking to show you what my thought process is and how I end up decorating, or showing how I my creative process. So I'm building the book, sorry, bag, purse, I keep saying book, excuse me. Then I am going to finish by snipping those little edges. And I pulled out a couple of things that I had already laying around. I am currently working on something else with this collection, so I had it already out. And as you can see, I don't know exactly what I'm doing. I'm just kind of working with what I have already out. I have a couple of actual ephemera and printed ones from the digital collection. This really pretty piece of tulle that I got. It has like glittery sparkly pieces on it. And I knew I wanted to make it thick and chunky because my recipient is going to display it, and I wanted it to have a beautiful dimension. And so yeah, I'm just, that teal piece that I just put on was actually just a scrap that was laying there, and I know for sure I want to use the big top. And I'm just gonna put in some foam. There's so much foam, so much glue, so much dimension going on in the final piece that I really liked it. Now this little swan right here, I want to turn it into one of those, like the ride, the carousel ride that kind of goes up and down, kind of like that zebra right there. I like making my own from the swan. I do it very often, and I think that's one of my favorite kind of things. So I'm pulling out all these different elements that would go on to the swan, and that's a die cut. I do have the die cut, and I ordered it. I have no idea from whom I ordered this. I don't know. I really don't know. So anyway, I am it's kind of flimsy. The paper that I use is glittery and it's a little bit flimsy, so I'm punching out this circle and going to add it to the back of it just to add a little bit of a sturdiness to it. And I'm putting that clear acrylic block on top while I finish picking out what I want to do. And I'm using these white, they're actually for flowers and it's a white leaf, but I think it looks really good as feathers, as the wings of the swan. And yeah, I think it looks cute. So I'm gonna add it on and I'm gonna add it with a little bit of dimension so that it looks like it's popped up. I love texture and dimension and stuff like that. So I'm still picking out what I want the top of this straw to be, or it would be the pole. So I brought out a couple of beads and then I hit the camera. Sorry, I think I hit it like twice. And I brought out some beads, some little pom-poms, and a little bead. And I think I said bead twice. Anyways, so I ended up picking this very shiny white one. I think it looks pretty good, considering how this one is actually glittery. Once you see it, it kind of works. The camera doesn't do justice. And some bows that I got from a friend from Australia, which I'm working on her stuff as well. I've got so much projects, half-finished projects, because my daughter's graduation was going on and I had to put everything on hold. I had a couple of orders for school stuff and lays, and so yeah, this is back to my regularly scheduled crafting. But yeah, look at how cute that is. So I'm looking and seeing if I can add in a couple of extra things here and there. And I wanted to add in some balloons and just all over. I felt like it wasn't done. The more I add, somebody said this, and I think it was Abby from Cat Paper Love, and she said, the more I add, the more I want to continue adding. And that's kind of what it was for me right here. And I really wanted to use that word, the fun word. It wasn't working. And I really liked it. So I pulled out the chipboard and it's almost finishing. I need to order another one. So I added a couple of hearts and some tickets, chipboard. And I wanted to put in this this little banner with some words in it. So I thought I had it in a digital, but I didn't. So I ended up putting up the chipboard. I think it looks good after a while. Good thing. I'm glad I used the chipboard instead of using a flat ephemera piece. And then I'm pulling out some sequins and I'm going to add them sporadically around and kind of clustering them together, the gold, the white, and the hot pink. But yeah, that is so far what I have. I think it looks really cute. And then as I was doing this, I was thinking, oh, I think she'll like to display it and it'll be cute for her to see this side of it and it'd be nice. And then I thought, well, I'm a little bit extra, so let's just do the back. And this one come on. If she wants to change it up, she could just turn the bag around and the other side is decorated as well. I think it's cute. This side, however, I wanted to leave it not as texturized, not as dimensional as the first one. So I was trying to go with as flat as I could possibly go, with a couple of pop dots, like two or three. That's it. That's all I wanted. But again, I'm extra and it didn't end up going the way I wanted it. And I ended up putting that piece of tulle down, hitting the camera, then adding in a stitched piece of striped gold and white that I had there. Adding page flags flags on, and a picture, a Polaroid. And then I noticed that the flag and the camera kind of had the same kind of pattern on it. And then I was finally able to use that word. I wanted to use the fun word. I mean, carnivals, carousels, they're fun. You have to use in that word. So I glued it down on the tickets. I have a whole spool of those tickets that I need to use. And I think I've had them since, I want to say, October. Yeah. So adding in some more sequins, some more dimension, and finally topping it off with a chipboard ticket here to add a little bit of color right there. But that's what I did, and I hope you guys liked it. Here's some stills. I think it looks really pretty. I think it looks very girly, and that's what I was going for. Again, this is my favorite collection, so whenever I feel like I need Inspiration, this is my go-to because it has all my favorite things, the colors, cameras, pictures, swans, and fun girly colors. I hope she likes it, and thank you guys for stopping by and checking out my channel. Bye guys.